think it is totally genius to drop down to the ground and act like you're possessed. Hey guys, it's Sharon. Like I have mentioned plenty of times before, and if you haven't heard it yet, I don't know why, but I'm not gonna judge. I am making nothing but spooky content this month because it's October, it's spooky time. 2020 has been pretty rough. We deserve all the spooks we can get right now. Okay, okay. So obviously, you know that I do my period horror stories every month, and if you didn't know, now you do. So this is a perfect excuse to make it Halloween period horror stories. I have done this before. I did this last year, so if you like to see last year's version, definitely check that out. But of course, here's the brand new 2021. So if you want to see more, give us a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below. Follow me on my Instagram and my Twitter so you can be in my videos just like this one. And I not only just have Halloween period horror stories, I actually have a whole all about periods playlist. So if you want to see more, I got you, sis. And you can always subscribe for more. And also, if you did not know, I have been doing monthly giveaways this year, so there will be a spooky related giveaway in this video. But enough about that, go grab your spooky snack, spooky tea, spooky pads, tampons, cups, I don't know, whatever you use, and let's get into this. One Halloween, I spent the night at my grandma's house with my cousins. My aunt was there too, and so was her dog that was on her period. While I was asleep, my cousins thought it would be funny to take the dog's period diaper that was full of blood and smear it all over the walls to scare me. Let's just say they didn't have too much fun cleaning that. That is what we like to call karma, because this is disgusting. I mean, I don't look at a dog's bloody diaper and be like, you know what, I'm gonna go smear this all over the walls of grandma's house. I feel like the last thing you want to do is cause any issues and ruckus at grandma's house, because everyone knows grandma don't play, okay? And if you have a grandma that likes to play, you are very lucky. But I just know if that's a Spanish grandma, you're dead. And then you can become the actual ghost that leaves blood on the walls and wants to scare your cousin. So yeah, lesson learned. Also, just really nasty that they would look at period blood and be like, let me smear it on the walls. That's just weird. Go get some, I don't know, fake blood, make some fake blood, use some jello before it hardens. There's so many other things that could have been done before using period blood from a dog. Super weird. But anyways, I was going as the classic ghost for a party and just happened to start my period and got blood on it. So I told people that I changed my costume to a tampon. See, this is smart. It's original too, and you're owning up to it. And hey, you're spreading more awareness of tampons are okay. Let's drop the stigma around periods. And we love that, and we stand. I mean, typical Halloween hacked. If you get your period and you stain through your Halloween costume, you are now a bloody version of whatever costume you have. You can't go wrong with it. I mean, Halloween is all about fake blood. And how realistic is it if you have actual blood, you know? No one knows, so perfect. My friend's little sister is really annoying, so she used her period blood to paint her sister's Halloween makeup. See, I don't have a little sister, so I don't know how annoying they can be, but I'd like to think that I wouldn't find anyone annoying enough to use my period blood on their face. I feel like that's very evil. Something's not right up here, you know, and it leaves me very concerned, and I feel like that's very not healthy. Something tells me that period blood should not be smeared on your face. It just sounds, very nasty. My parents said we should make our own costumes. My sister and I thought this was a pretty cool idea, and we ended up wrapping her in toilet paper to look like a mummy. Well, come Halloween night, while we were at a trunk or treat, I got my first period. Long story short, my sister donated half her costume so I could clean up. How in clutch did this sister come? So now you know, guys, if you're just a group of friends, make sure that one of you is dressed up in toilet paper as a mummy, because you never know when your period's gonna hit and you might need some extra toilet paper. So there, life hack, problem solved. And then if you become a bloody mummy, you got toilet paper, and suddenly you're a bloody mummy too. I mean, all around wins over here. When I was 10, I went to a Halloween party and I dressed up as a dead cheerleader. I had fake blood on my face and arms. During the party, someone said to me that they liked how I have fake blood down my leg. Let's just say I went to the party as a girl and came out a lady. Again, super lucky that now you're just a even more dead version of the costume you already were, and now you're a lady. So you look cool with all this blood, and you're a woman now. We love it though. I got my period while at a Halloween party, and I thought it would look cool to leave bloody handprints on the cups for decoration, and everyone loved them. You mean to tell me that this person had their first ever period and they're like, wow, it would look so cool if I grabbed my hand, collected my period blood, and went around touching things, leaving my bloody handprints on the cups for decoration? Could you imagine grabbing a cup? You're grabbing some punch, you're really thirsty, you're dehydrated, and you're like, look at this cool handprint. Oh, that's so cool. Wait a second. why is it on my hand and why does it look a lot like actual blood? And then you find out it's pure blood and never go to another Halloween party ever again. I would have been traumatized, and I am a little bit traumatized even though I wasn't even there. Disgusting. My cousin was going as a zombie for Halloween and she was on her period. She ran out of fake blood and all the shops were closed, so she used her period blood on her body to finish it off. The next day we had to go to the ER because her face swelled and was full of rashes. The doctor said it's because of the period blood mixed with the fake blood. You see, I told you something didn't sound right about putting period blood all over your face, and this just goes to show that. I mean, granted, it didn't mix well with something, but also just period blood really shouldn't go on your face. I'm just gonna say that for the rest of this video. And guys, even if the shops were closed and you can't find fake blood, I mean, there's so many other things. A melted red popsicle, ketchup. Most houses have ketchup. Just some food dye. I don't know. So many other things except period blood. Okay? Okay. Even a red marker. Like, just draw it on. It's not that deep. It's just Halloween. It's just one night of a costume. It's dark. No one's gonna notice if it's marker or not. Anything but the period blood. I understand accidentally using period blood as a costume, but purposefully doing it? No. That's where I draw the line. And the line's not made out of period blood, FYI. It was Halloween and my family was throwing a Halloween party. I had my period, so I went to the restroom to take off my pad and put it in the trash. Later, I found my used pad in the punch bowl just floating around. Nobody drank any more punch. I'm very glad that no one else drank the punch because I would be very concerned if someone saw a used pad floating in the punch, whether or not it was decoration they didn't know and they still drank from it. So at least everyone is making some smart moves at this party. But I want to know who the person is that made the dumb move to go digging in the bathroom trash can, pulled out a dirty pad, and went to put it in the punch. I am concerned. No more Halloween parties. That's all I've learned so far. My crush and I decided to go trick-or-treating. We got to an old lady's house and she looked at me funny. I ignored her, then turned around just for her to pull me. I thought she was abducting me and screamed for help. Then she screamed, "You got period blood all over your skirt, you idiot." It was so embarrassing and my crush legit left me there. It was mortifying. I understand how you could think you're being kidnapped by a woman at her house, but yo, she was a real one low-key for being like, "No, you just have blood." But I love how she's like, "You have blood, you idiot. I don't want you." But can we actually talk about the crush that ran? Just left this girl high and dry. Bye. He said, "Not me." I can't blame him low-key, but also maybe not the best crush to have. I do feel like the old lady didn't have to pull her and yank her. Like, she could have just said, "Hey, by the way, you got blood back there," versus aggressively grabbing someone. But I don't know. To each their own, I guess. My friend was a pregnant woman for Halloween, and of course, Mother Nature came. She was bleeding all the way down the street, and a man came up to her and called 911 because he thought she was actually pregnant. "See, sir, so this is my period, meaning that I am not pregnant, and I feel like now we know. We can't dress as pregnant women for Halloween," and I feel like that has to be low-key offensive because there are some women out there that really want to get pregnant and want to have a kid of their own but can't get pregnant, so I feel like doing a costume out of this is a little bit offensive, but hey, you live and you learn, and now this man knows that when a woman has a period, she's not pregnant. But lots of lessons going around. I went trick-or-treating with my friend and my boyfriend. He touched my butt. I asked him to stop, but he wouldn't. As he was touching my butt, I got my period and leaked all over his hand. And that is what we like to call karma. So there's also another thing called consent. If you're not given consent, don't do something. And if you're told to stop something, stop something. And if you don't listen to it, then you might just get a bloody hand or a bloody punch to the face. You know, whichever one you want to go with, whichever one happens first. But it all comes back around anyways. I was trick-or-treating and apparently left a trail of blood. Some kids behind us screamed in horror, and I turned around to see the blood. So I dropped to the floor and acted like I was in some horror show. This is my favorite reaction. Like, it's Halloween. You're allowed to do weird, crazy things, you know? I think it is totally genius to drop down to the ground and act like you're possessed because you're covering your trail, literally. So, kind of a life hack right here, not gonna lie. And those kids were probably even more freaked out. And I mean, that's the point of Halloween, freaking out children, right? Right. I had gotten my period and I didn't realize it until I woke up. I went to the bathroom and there wasn't blood in my panties. And it was then that I realized there was a bottle of fake blood on my dresser from my dad that said, "No need to get the tampons yet." Not gonna lie, this is probably one of the best pranks that a dad could do on Halloween, or like any parent, older sibling, whatever, can do on Halloween. I mean, granted, you got some stained sheets now and you're gonna have to wash them, but I feel like it would have been worth it for the prank. So I love this dad. We stan him. Sorry to the person that got pranked by their dad though. I had my first period on Halloween, so we were on my porch and my friend said, "Hey, this fake blood looks so real," and started licking it. I've mentioned this so many times before. You guys know how I feel about suspicious liquids and people licking suspicious liquids. That's just like Darwinism at its finest. But my thing is, if you see fake blood, like fake Halloween blood, whether it's real or not, period blood, fake blood, we don't know, why are you gonna lick it? Fake blood isn't meant to be ate. You don't know what chemicals and dyes are in there. Why are you putting that inside your mouth? It's stuff like that that doesn't add up, and it's stuff like that that doesn't make me feel bad for these people. You had it coming. You're testing, licking, drinking suspicious liquids. I can't help you there. My sister told me about a lady down the street who had a miscarriage. She told me that if blood comes out of your vagina around Halloween time, it was the lady's dead baby coming to haunt you. I got my period 2 days before Halloween and ran around the house yelling, "I'm cursed, I'm cursed." But I feel like if I'm getting my first period on Halloween and I had no idea what a period was, I would be extra freaked out. A haunted demon baby? Yeah, no thank you. I mean, I don't know if it's a demon baby, but I feel like anything that's gonna come back and like haunt you and possess you from inside your body sounds like a demon if you ask me, so I'm out. Someone used their used pad as decoration. I wonder if this person went to that party where they had the used pad in the punch bowl and they're like, that's weird decoration. Coincidence? We'll never know. But either way, I mean, to be honest, Halloween decorations are about it being scary and creepy and disturbing, and a used pad sounds very disturbing. So got the job done very disgustingly, but it did it. I got my period and I didn't have pads or tampons. I just collected my blood in small cups and sold it as fake blood for $2. I mean, this is a businesswoman right here. She's making profit off of her own blood. Good for you for being a businesswoman and being a shark thinking like one, but not good for you for it being your period blood. That's really gross, really disturbing, really concerning, and I'm a little bit scared right now. I'm not gonna lie. But lesson learned, don't ever buy fake blood from people because you don't know if it's really fake blood or where it's coming from. So yeah, just use ketchup. Thanks to Sharon. Now every time I see blood on costumes, wonder if it actually is period blood, and also don't drink any red drinks now. You are welcome, and it's so true. Now every Halloween, are you really bloody or did you have an accident? The world may never know, but we are a little bit more suspicious over here on this channel, and I don't know y'all. I mean, like, unless you made your own red drink, maybe be very alert about other red drinks and fake blood and use pads all over the place. I don't know. This is just getting real nasty and real creepy and disturbing, and I mean, I love Halloween, but I don't love this side of Halloween. But anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below. If you have your own Halloween period horror story that you would like to share, go ahead and do that if I did not expose it already. Shout of the day goes to Genesis on Instagram. Thank you so, so much. If you would like to be shout of the day, just follow me on my Instagram and stay active. And I know what you're thinking now. Okay, sis, where is this spooky giveaway? So this month, you can win this little spooky gift bag. It says trick or treat. I think it is so cute. Also, these cat's earmuffs, because I know it's about to get cold for some of y'all. I mean, I live in Florida. It doesn't really get that cold here, but up in the north, y'all are cold, okay? This super cute holographic notebook. I actually have the same one, and this is where I write all my spooky video ideas. A cotton candy face mask, because, I mean, candy, Halloween, trick-or-treat yourself. It makes sense. This fairy dust highlighter. I think it is so cute. A little phone ring for your cell phone. This makes holding your phone super easy and super cute. And this dream chaser eyeshadow palette. Look at that. Beautiful. If you guys want to win this, it's real easy. So all you have to do is be subscribed to my channel and comment down on this video. You can use the comment of the day, and I will also have a Google form that I want you to fill out with your information so that way I can contact you if you are my winner. If you would like bonus entries, make sure to follow me on my Instagram and check out my giveaway post, tag your friends, leave some comments for bonus entries too. So that being said, good luck. If you would like to see more videos, like I mentioned, I have a bunch more period related videos on my channel. I have a whole all about periods playlist, and I will be making a lot more spooky videos for the rest of this month. If you haven't seen the ones I made already, make sure to check those out as well. But all that being said, I will see you guys next time. Bye.